Grace, mercy, and peace to you all. In the name of God, our Father, and our Lord and Savior, Jesus. Amen. If you join me in a word of prayer. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, and we thank you for this word. And that Jesus speaks to us about who he is, who you are, and who we are in him. Lord, as we listen and as we take this word to heart, may we be these branches that are in this vine. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. A little bit of context happening before we dig in too far. John 13 to 17, I mentioned this last week, is this kind of extended commentary of Jesus on a whole bunch of stuff. And so you have John 15 kind of right in the middle of it. Jesus has been talking for a while. This is Monday, Thursday. They're having this conversation before they go out to the Garden of Gethsemane. The thing that's happening in John 15, one of the things that's actually kind of odd about these chapters is that there's kind of no controversy happening. Like, Jesus he's going to be crucified, he's kind of addressing all of that, but there's no, like, questions. So lots of times when you look at the Bible and you're reading them through the Gospels, there's some sort of question. Like, somebody asks Jesus a question, and Jesus is giving some sort of response to that question. There's no question here, right? He's kind of going off. Is what he's doing. He's kind of like, he wants you to know, these are the things that he wants you to know before what happens happens, right? He knows what's going to happen. He's been telling them what's going to happen. He wants his people to know what will happen before it happens. And then when that thing happens, what happens, right? You clear on that? We good? Right, he wants you to know after this whole crucifixion, resurrection thing, how are you to think about what it is to be in him? How do the Christians think about this? And so Jesus, he's doing this. And so after this, or after John 17, they'll go out to the garden, the arrest, the trial, things will just start to move very, very, very quickly. So Jesus is taking these last few minutes, really, before all of that happens, to tell his disciples, what do you do? What do you do with all of this? And in the way in which he chooses to do it is he chooses to talk about this living system, right? If he were here today and this was all going on right now, that would be interesting and different, right? He might not choose a living organism because we here in 21st century Western worlds, we have lots of technology. He might sit down with his disciples, he might talk about how he is the television and they are the Netflix app, right? He is, and apart from them, him, you cannot watch great British shows, right? That's how he would do it. No, it's one of the things, like, he's really speaking into this world where people know how things grow, and so this living organism, this living system, this vine and these branches, right? That's the system that he's talking about. There's a vine, and that's kind of the source. It has it's kind of the beginning of anything that comes off of it. And so he says, I'm the vine, right? And then from that vine grow branches. You see this, an olive tree is a very kind of short tree, and so it has a kind of center, and then it has branches that grow off of it. And then, so I am the vine, you are the branches, and then as branches, we're not idiots, we know this, right? You look at an apple tree or other trees, I mean, there's center, branches, and then there's fruit, right? The fruit does not hang on the center. The fruit does not sit there on the center of the tree. It hangs off of the branches. And so I am the vine. I am the center. I am the source. I am the place where it all begins. You are the branches. And from the branches comes fruit. The branches have this very unique position. They are there. They are connected to this tree because if a branch falls off your apple tree, it no longer produces fruit. If you cut a branch off your apple tree, it no longer produces fruit. You can stare at it, you can encourage it, you can yell at it, right? How many of you have ever done that? You look at a branch, come on, flower, right? Blossom for me. If you do, you're weird, and that's just weird, right? Because it's not going to, because it no longer has its connection back to the source. It no longer has its connection to life. And so the other side of it, the fruit-bearing part of it, is not going to happen. It's not going to happen. And we know this. And what Jesus is telling them as he tells them this story, this metaphor about what they're going to do, how they should think of themselves after what happens, he says, I'm the vine. You are the branches. And apart from me, there is no fruit. In this gospel, he uses the word remain a lot. Some of you grew up on King James, it's abide in King James translations, which is where you get the abide with me as a hymn. But it's remain. The word is meno. In Greek, meno is to remain, to be there. And he says, this is how there's fruit. And in using this metaphor, there's kind of this challenge for us. Do you recognize that you need him to, you need him on this side? This branch has to be connected over here in order to have fruit over here. Do you recognize this? And we look at nature and like, of course, you can't just yell at the branch to have fruit. It's not going to happen if it's not connected. Do you recognize it or do you reject it? Right? There's a level to which Jesus is looking and he's speaking and he's addressing them, and I believe he's addressing us. Do we live connected to this source? Because if we don't, we shouldn't be surprised if we have no fruit. Like that shouldn't be shocking to us. And so Jesus, as he's doing this, he's motivated by this love that he has for us, that it would be a love that would be shared by us. See, one of the important things about fruit on any sort of living organism, so you've got this vine, you've got these branches, you've got the tree, you've got branches, and you have fruit. And the important thing about that fruit over here is that it's not for the branches. And it's not for the vine. The fruit of a plant is for something else. It's for you. We had an apple tree when I was growing up. And it was a terrible apple tree. maybe it wasn't a terrible apple tree. Maybe we didn't really take care of it. But the fruit would always like fall. It would lose apples. The apples didn't taste very good, so we never picked them. And the apples would fall eventually, and then the whole driveway would be full of apples, and the whole driveway would be full of bees. And then, anybody have one of those trees? Okay. The fruit is meant to be out into the world, right? Jesus wants the love, the source, this life that flows through him, this love that flows through him, to come through the branches to be fruit so that other people may have that fruit from him. So Jesus, as he wants this, he gives you this one simple word again and again and again and again and again in John 15, 1 through 8. And that one simple word is remain. We remain. We say yes, absolutely. Without that vine, I have no life. Without that vine, I have no fruit. Without that vine, there is nothing, and it's I mean, my children will take up sticks and use them as guns, but otherwise there's kind of nothing to do with the branches that have fallen. There's nothing to do with the branches that do not want to be connected in the vine. There's nothing to do with the branches that have somehow rejected this center. They will not bear fruit. They have no other purpose other than to be burned. So we remain. We remain. We say one of the most fundamental things about us as the Christian people is that our being in Jesus, our source, we are not wholly independent, self-sufficient beings. We do not exist in a way or in a purpose that says, I am an entity unto myself. We say, I need the vine to live. And I, as I live in that vine, I will bear fruit, but it's not fruit for me. It is fruit for others. And the way in which we are able to live in this Jesus, to be in this Jesus, is to remain, to abide, to dwell, to be. We be in Him. And this is what He offers us today. How do you do it? Well, He does it. Right? But there's definitely, absolutely, a place for us to say, am I remaining? Do I look for my source? Am I interested in there being fruit that goes out into this world? There's a place for us to say that, to ask ourselves about this, and then to say unto Jesus, Jesus, you are the vine and I am a branch. Prune me. Let me be more fruitful. Let me be someone who remains in you, who bears much fruit for the sake of this world, for the sake of your people. Jesus, this for me, please. And that's what we got today. That's what the Word takes us to. It takes us to a level of reflection that says, Jesus, I look to you as my source. Jesus, I want to be fruitful for this world. Lord Jesus, be with me and help me to be so. In your name, amen. Lord, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to reflect on who we are. Thank you for being our vine, our source, our life. Thank you for putting the Spirit out into this world to move among us, to say, Lord, that we have this place that is in you. And Lord, thank you for inviting us to look that if we're going to take this living system, this living organism, that we are able to say, prune us, shape us, help us to be your people here in this time. In your most precious name, Jesus. Amen.